Hello students, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Well, if you have reached this video, I'm sure you must have already visited the previous video which gives a line-wise explanation of this chapter. The chapter We Are Not Afraid to Die by Gordon Cook and Alan East is the second chapter in your Hornbill textbook for class 11. In this video, we will be doing just for exams question bank and focusing only on the text questions. The text questions are listed here. We will be taking them up one by one. So I'm going directly to the next slide, which shows us the first question. Understanding the text, list the steps taken up by the captain to protect the ship when the rough weather began. The narrator had decided to actually slow down the ship to protect it from the bad and stormy weather. And there are specifically 4 or 5 things that I have asked you to keep in mind. He dropped the storm jib, lashed the heavy mooring rope across the stern of the ship doubled twice, and they carried their life raft drill out, attached the lifelines, and donned life jackets and oilskins. By donning, I mean they wore them. So all this has been described in detail when we did the line-wise explanation of the text. Coming to the second question. The second question talks about list the steps taken by the captain to check the flooding of the water in the ship. To check the flooding of the water in the ship, what did he do? He put a waterproof hatch over the gaping holes, and this helped in diverting the water and flow to the side. His hand pumps were blocked due to debris, and his one electric pump, which had not been thrown overboard, was actually short-circuited. He realized and he did not lose his presence of mind, and he realized he had a spare electric pump. That electric pump was connected with the outpipe, and it was able to check the flooding of the water in the ship. Coming to the next question, describe the mental condition of the voyagers on the 4th and 5th of January. On the 4th of January, the voyagers felt relieved as they were continuously pumping out the water, and only a few centimeters of water was left because they were doing that for the last 36 hours. They had their first meal in 2 days. Mary found some beef and cracker biscuits. Later around 4 p.m., the weather changed into black clouds, and the wind was now 40 knots. That's a lot of speed, children, in sea. And the sea was getting higher. That means the volume of the water was rising. The weather got worse by the early of January 5, and this gave them a lot of mental stress. So in this question, we have to talk about the mental condition whenever we are talking about what happens. So if we don't write mental stress, we don't write they were relieved, the answer does not seem to be correct. The third question here is, describe the shifts in the narration of the events as indicated in the 3 sections of the text. Give a subtitle to each section. This is a long answer question, children. In the text question series, I do not segregate the short answer questions from the long answer questions. And therefore, I hope this makes it easy for you when I give some answers, some catch points along with it. So this is how we'll divide the first section. The first section can be said to be the beginning of the round, the voyage, And the first section was cheerful and full of hope, as they had planned to do a similar round the earth voyage as Captain James Cook did. The second section can be described as a struggle with the big attack. In this section, the family was under great pressure to survive the oncoming waves and bad weather. From cheerful, they turned tense and intense in terms of their mood. There was a lot of chaos and the ship was about to overturn. It was caused due to a giant wave, and the narrator was thrown almost off the water, overboard, and he almost drowned and got injured. Along with two hired crewmen, the narrator pumped out the water from the ship for a continuous 36 hours. He also tried to repair the parts of the ship. He almost lost his hope and believed they would die. But his children were fearless and courageous enough, which gave him the determination to fight back. Coming to the third section, we can say, we can call it as victory. Because the narrator tried his best to find the two islands, Isle Amsterdam. They finally reached the destination despite in between he felt like giving up hope. But here in this answer, we need not write all that, because it's not asking about what were his feelings at this time. So you just need to say in the third section they were able to find Isle Amsterdam, and thus they were able to save themselves, and the children found that their parents were really successful. Now let's look at the other set of text questions talking about the text, and we will look at them one by one again. What difference did you notice between the reaction of the adults and the children when faced with danger? Now, when there was a huge difference between the reaction of the adults and the children. The adults lost their hope and at the end they almost had given up, whereas the children, on the other hand, were very hopeful. With the support of his children, Jonathan and Suzanne, the narrator, decided that he has to find out the island at any cost. The children showed more maturity than they did. And his son expressed courage that they were not afraid to die if they all were together. And the way that his daughter had made a card expressing his love and affection for his parents also sent across a beautiful message. She was injured still. She didn't let that become the hue and cry and the center of attraction for her parents. And all this behavior of the children was able to support the adults in this dire situation. The second question asks and talks about how does the story suggest that optimism helps to endure dire stress? Well, without optimism, nothing is possible. Optimism is the determination to overcome any challenges. Without it, it is impossible to face difficulties and solve problems. The family fought with the sea, okay? And it was with optimism and determination they were attacked. Though they were attacked by the sea waves and the sea, they didn't stop trying to find the Isle Amsterdam island. When the son of the narrator told him that they weren't afraid of dying if they were all together, that also gave them a lot of hope. And Sue, who made a card, because she was very proud of her parents, all these things added to a lot of optimism, and it gave the parents the desire and determination to cling on to that optimism. Okay, I've given just some points here. You can write it in your own words. Don't copy it as it is. It will not help. Coming to the third question, what lessons do we learn from the such hazardous experiences when we are face to face with death? Well, if you look at this, life is never about being happy all the time. We are constantly tested, and how we tackle every problem is actually what helps us to rise through it. such hazardous situations teach us how we should react towards them. Okay, in certain situations, we must always try to keep calm and think logically. No matter how bad the situation, we will always get out of it. And the significance is also to be extra cautious. Remember what he does, the life raft drill, and what all five things he took care of and waited for the impending storm at the beginning of the chapter. So only being optimistic is not only the solution, it has to be also assisted with being extra cautious and also remaining calm and thinking logically. Let's go to the fourth question, which is the last question. Why do you think that people undertake such adventurous expeditions in spite of the risks involved? See, there's a willingness to accept challenges that drives people to take such kind of expeditions. People like to try different elements of nature and turn it into a passion. Surely people know the risks are involved in such activities, but still they do not try to hesitate to try it out. That's why children, many of you might go for a hiking expedition, right? After 12th standard, there are students who go in 11th and 12th if their parents allow. So you do that. You go for river rafting. You go for all these kind of different activities, which you know. You go for bungee jumping. What's the reason behind that? The reason is the willingness to accept the challenge. Okay, let me overcome the fear of water. So it's like saying to overcome the fear of height and let me surge into that and let me plunge into that, and then only I'll be able to do that, overcome it. So people take up such adventurous expeditions despite the risks involved, because it's nature to, that's just the way to overcome one's fear. So children, I hope you've understood the chapters. Every time I say you've understood the chapters, you've understood the questions, but what I really mean to say is here, I hope you feel the need of these chapters is to send across a message that you can do really well. So I hope you visit my channel, subscribe to it. And before this, you must have visited the line by line explanations. The next two videos I'll be taking up are short answer questions and another separate one on long answer questions. There will be around 10 to 15 short answer questions and say around 8 or 7 long answer questions. I don't really know right now, but you will definitely benefit from that. Hope to see you. Visit those videos as well. Till then, bye-bye. Love you all.